I am absolutely opposed to that interpretation. A living woman is different from a dead one.
I can't be as categorical as you.
Dylan, the woman you love cannot leave you indifferent.
I am astonished at your concern.
I'm Terry O'Brien, and I'm a director and a playwright. I've spent many years directing Shakespeare, and more recently I've started to develop my own material.
It was only later I discovered you could make yourself come on your own.
I'm working on a project called Investigating Sex, which is an adaptation of some conversations that the Paris Surrealists had in the late 1920s, where they would get together in a room, sit around a table on a Friday night with cocktails and cigarettes, and they would ask questions about sex and then answer them as honestly and as frankly as they could.
That's not a choice, it's an instinct.
I've kind of been directing it in my head while I've been writing it. So now this is a chance for me to materially put live people with the script in an environment and see, you know, how to make sense of it.
I am astonished at your concern with the concrete. I take this to be a form of confusion.
How do you imagine the idea of becoming impotent?
I cannot accept any hypothesis which
I think diminishes. One of the challenges is to try to be seen and be honest at the same time. I'm just trying to bring my work in front of the public without catering, I guess, to maybe a commercial impulse, because I don't have any commercial impulses, really.
You hearing the question helps us.
A few years ago at BAC, I developed a project called Popular Mechanics, which was a one-person show about growing up in the Cold War. I grew up in a small rural community outside of Minneapolis called Watertown. 1,000 people, we could go to the end of our street and see cattle on the hillside. I think about that a lot. I get focused when I'm in a rural environment, but I think I'm more creative when I'm in the city.
Who is claimed to the contrary?
The validity of everything that has been said here so far has been partially undermined by the inevitable predominance of the male point of view.
At BAC, the environment is very clean and clear.
February 15th, 1928.
And I think that inspires clean and clear and simple choices.
I would like someone to prove to me that a woman is actually alive.
Oh, thoroughgoing materialism.
Anti-surrealist.
Working on it in residence, things are remarkably neat in our process and direct, and I think that's partly a function of the, you know, the clarity of the environment.
When I'm with a lover, I commit everything to that moment. Everything. And when we're finished, they know all they can possibly know. Their desire for me is so satisfied that they no longer want me.